Hey, my name is Ryan Rusnak. I'm the CTO of Airspace Technologies. We're a time-critical freight forwarder up in Carlsbad, California. They say being a CTO is a really lonely position because when you're speaking to the business, you're the technology guy. When you're speaking to the technologists, you're the business guy. So it's a pretty lonely position in general. So being able to get together once a month with people that are in the same position as you, with similar challenges to you, is great for a lot of reasons. You can bounce problems off them, they can really help you work through them. You can just vent to them and they can help you deal with your frustrations. And then when they have problems, you can give them advice. And if they take it, it makes you feel really, really good.
My name is Mina Janeri and I'm the VP of Engineering for the Zebra. I had just been promoted into a VP of Engineering role and wanted to really find a peer group that I could talk through struggles, learn from, hopefully provide a different perspective. Given that my path wasn't traditional, I think this group is just beneficial for any leader who really just wants to dig in and process problems and challenges that they're going through and hear that they're not alone.
Hi, I'm Bill View from Casual Fridays, and I'm a member of 7 CTOs in the first forum that started here in San Diego. When I moved to San Diego in 2010, this type of organization didn't exist, and boy, I wish it did. I was trying to solve hard people and process problems alone, and if I'd had 7 CTOs, I would have had an organization filled with members ready to help, people I could connect with, people that could help coach me to be a better leader, a better manager, and more effective in my role.
Hi, my name is Dwayne McLeish. I'm the CEO and founder of Journaly. I think that every CTO, in my opinion, needs to have a people foundation that they try to build, which this organization helps you build. And then obviously from an engineering perspective, from a technical perspective, there's a wealth of knowledge in the community. Just in the Slack channel alone, you can gain insight into how you could possibly tackle a sweeping challenge. I believe that we will have better, more mindful technical leaders, better engineering, because people will be set up for success through the wealth of knowledge in the network.
Hi, Larry Heminger. I'm CIO with MEM Computing. Kind of started several years ago. I was promoted into an executive management position at a company here in San Diego, and I was thinking about maybe I should, you know, go with an executive coach. And right about that time, one of my peers introduced me to Etienne. The great thing is the diversity. We all work at different companies, but we all have that role of, you know, the lead technology person in your company. And that means something different to every person, but we all have that responsibility. And being able to bring a challenge to that forum, you know, on a monthly basis, being able to get a diverse set of opinions and feedback just has really been a very, very large value to me.
Hi, my name is Sigalit Sadok, Siggy. I am a member of 7 CTOs. I'm also the CTO of a company called Kelvy. 7 CTOs has helped me tremendously, both in doing what I'm doing today, as well as building my confidence to do what I need to do in the future. I believe that 7 CTOs has given me and can give people the tools that they need to be a good technology leader in whatever technology field you're in.
I'm Ken Cohn. I'm the CTO of Radius Labs. And the reason that I joined 7 CTOs was because I had just moved, just got this new job. I knew nobody, I had no community. I didn't know where my tribe was or who my tribe even was. I was a new CTO. And I just needed that community. And I found it. How does it help others? What are your challenges? Like real honest people holding each other accountable respectfully and supporting each other. I don't know if you could get any better help than that.